it's here, and I can't even wait till 8 a.m. to open it. Actually, I already put the box open, but I didn't realize I wasn't recording the whole time, so we'll pretend that I didn't already. Yes! I bet you can guess what I recently purchased when I said on Twitter I bought something new. The GH5s. No one actually guessed it, honestly. A lot of people thought it was the Mavic Air. Other people thought it was a different camera altogether. A lot of you have been thinking that I'm getting rid of the GH5s altogether. No, I just added another one. And I'm not gonna go through the whole unboxing. We know what's in it. It's a booklet. It's a strap I've never once used for a remote. USB-C cable charger. I actually changed the charger. I like this one. It's a lot smaller than the other one. AC charger for it, cable, the thing that keeps the cables in on the side, and a battery. So I guess I went through an unboxing anyway, but let's get to the important thing. Here is the moment we've all been waiting for. Pretty exciting. So, I didn't expect it to change the way it felt very much, but it feels pretty much identical. The buttons feel a lot stiffer than the GH5, but probably just because it's brand new. They didn't really change much. All the glory was obviously changed on the inside. Let's put a lens on her. Looks identical, feels identical. These things are still the dumbest designs ever. I don't know why Sony and Panasonic have to do this, but they do. Okay, we're powering on. Please set the language, English, 7:56. I actually got this today at like noon, but I was gone all day. Then I got sick, and I'm still sick. This is just too important not to do. Memory card going in. Two memory card slots, of course, just like the other model. Let's change all this before I forget right away. Let's change our codecs. Let's change the record quality to the gorgeous 4K 10-bit. Gosh, there's so many options in this camera now. So now you got 4K 60, 8-bit, you got 4K 150, 10-bit, 30, you got 8-bit, 130, C4. There's just so many options now. 400 megabit, so many options. We will go to 4K. 10 bit, 24. That's what I use. And for this first test that I'm going to put it through, I'm actually going to keep it on standard profile. Not that I would ever use that, but I want to be able to show an immediate first impression of this camera. So I will let it do exactly what it needs to do. So obviously one of the biggest things that they changed with this camera is that they took away the in-body image stabilization, which is so unbelievable on the GH5. So I'm really, really curious to test that. I will definitely be doing some testing tomorrow on it and comparing the GH5 to the GH5S, because I'm really curious to see how good it does with just the lens stabilization in comparison to the full dual IS that they had between the body and the camera. It was so amazing on the GH5 that it's gonna be hard to not have it. So everything else looks good for the most part. So all the autofocus settings are the same, but did it get any better? Literally some of the things that I want to test immediately. And super excited, obviously, to test the low light. So first, I'm gonna put this to 50 frames at f2.8. It's really, really a bummer that they didn't put a new autofocus system on this thing. Of course, tomorrow I will do some testing on that to see if it did get any better. Initial impressions, not really. Looks like it's about the same. Maybe a little bit faster. Looks a little. Wait, I guess that was rude. I was like moving around looking at it. I didn't show you, so here, I'll show you. Definitely seems like it does better in certain things, and then seems like it's way worse in other things. It's definitely not good when it's up close, that's for sure. Once it's somewhat close to the focus, it looks like it grabs it decently. It's So initial impressions, just like any initial impressions video, is the fact that it looks great, looks similar, feels similar. The build quality hasn't changed, everything's still good. Excited to give it a test. I wanted to at least upload this to let you know there are a lot of GH5s videos coming. There's gonna be an autofocus test again, like usual. I'm gonna be able to knock that out right away for you guys to just see, did it get any better? I'm also gonna do a GH5s versus GH5 low light comparison video. I'm also gonna do a dual IS GH5 stabilization video versus the lens stabilization only on the GH5s, so let's see how different that is. I'm gonna do a lot of those videos and expect them all to drop a lot in the next probably 24 to 48 hours. I'm not even gonna stay on my normal schedule of uploading. I'm just gonna upload and upload, upload as soon as I finish them, because I know a lot of people will be curious to check out this camera. But overall, I'm super excited about it. And I'm excited to tell you a little bit more about how we're gonna use it. So, this is the most boring first impressions video ever, but prepare for a lot more coming. It's exciting, I'm super excited.